Chris, somebody here needs to hear this story. Several of you have already heard it, and just bear with the rest of us that need it. I need to tell it because it helps me just to remember where I came from and where I am. And I'm not going to get through without crying, and hopefully y'all won't hold that either. I mean, I like to have fun, and I laugh a lot, and that's fantastic, but the emotion that God gives you, that's just being able to touch you. But anyway, let me get started. I'm a fisherman, and I grew up doing it. My dad took me all the time, just fished ever since I can remember. And that never changed once I got married. And my wife and I, we lived on a lake. I had a little boat I kept right there by the pier where I lived. And I fished year-round. Rain, snow, sleet, it didn't matter. I was like a mailman. I got to go catch fish. But one morning, I worked all night, and I got home. And I didn't even go in the house. I set my lunch bucket on the steps. Reached to grab my minnow bucket, which was right beside my steps there. Took it down to the lake, stood in the boat, got in the boat, went fishing. I've got on a pair of coveralls, steel-toed boots, an army field jacket. This pocket was full of cigarettes. This pocket was full of stove. And I'm out there enjoying fishing. Nice, beautiful, sunshiny day, 24 degrees. It was beautiful, I'm telling you, it was beautiful. But, well, I'm the only nut on the lake, I think. And I'm fishing around there, and I'm plenty warm, you know. And I catch a few crappie and a few bream, and I got one stringer. And at this time, I'm probably 21 years old. And I'm fishing around there, just having a good time. I look over in this little cove, and there's a man sitting in a chair fishing off of a pier in this cove. The only man I'd seen all morning. Well, I didn't really want to clean those fish, and I just wanted to catch them. At this time, it warmed up to about 35 degrees, and I was over there where he was, and said, he said, I mean, I'm just disbelieving. I said, well, you want these fish? I'd be glad to give them to you. He said, oh, yeah. So I gave him all the fish I had. And I pulled out of that cove and started heading back toward the house where I lived. I was tired, you know, it's up to probably, 10:30, 11 o'clock by that time. And I had a little tackle box sitting on the front of my seat in front of me. It was a little flat bottom boat, 14 foot long, about that wide. And of course, I took up most of it. And I'm going up to there, and it's so cold that my hand is stiff on this rock. My tackle box starts vibrating, and I reach to grab it. But when I did, my hand slipped off the throttle, and the boat spun sideways, and it deposited me in the middle of the lake. My boat went around me twice, boat was still running wide open, and it left me. Well, I'm in the middle of this lake, and I start treading water. I took swimming lessons 3 years, but my sister couldn't swim. I learned the first year. She couldn't swim, so I went with her. But while they were learning to swim, I was such a rambunctious troublemaker, or like the, I wasn't troublemaker, I was a kid. The teacher would tell me, you just tread water while we're doing this. I'm talking for hours of treading water, So I learned to do that. If I'm treading water, I'm thinking the whole time, well, it's too far for me to swim to the shore, to the left, it's too far to the right. So I'm going to start praying. Lord, I've got a wife at home and a small child, and we got another one coming. I sure would like to see him grow up. And he said, take the coat off, So I take the coat off, I start to choke. Throw it above my head and try to make me a flotation device, but it didn't work. Just getting more and more water. Still treading water. Lord, if you're ready to take me, I'm ready to go. But I sure would like to see my wife and my daughter, my new son, just to be born. Just kept saying that over and over in my mind, Lord, if you're ready to go, if your child, I'm ready to go. I get to looking around, and in the distance, I see a boat, three figures in. I just seen a boat, just with three figures in. And I see one of them struggling toward the front, like they're pulling up an anchor or something. Well, I start whistling and wave my hands. Well, I'm starting to get tired. I've been in the water a good while. Well, the boat starts, you know, I see it get loose. Well, I'm too tired by that time, and I go under. Well, I think I'm just to drown. Well, I keep my way back to the top, just barely get my head above, and I can see the boat coming toward me, the wave just barely coming. And the figures are there, and they've got these hats, these brim hats on, big hats, big brim hats. They're coming toward me. I go back under again. Well, I get a little closer. I kicked hard as I could, pushed my arms up, and I reached up, and I hit the side of the boat. I pulled myself up, and there were three old ladies sitting in that boat. I threw my arms across the top of the front of the boat, and I said, Lord, thank you so much. And I said, ladies, thank you so much for saving my life. And they said, son, are you okay? I said, I'm about to freeze when you take me to the bank. So they drove me into the bank. Well, I got to the bank, I got out and started taking all my clothes off. I had them insulated underwear on under all these clothes. I piled them all up and set them in their boat. And these ladies never spoke other than just, are you okay? And for whatever reason, they said, you must have to find your boat. I said, yeah, I need to find it. They said, where is it? I said, last time I saw it was headed out toward the middle of the river. So they took me out toward the middle of the river, and my boat was pulled up against the side of the pier, the last pier in that lake, idle, like it was waiting. Motor still running, nothing damaged, it just sitting there waiting. So I tell those ladies, I said, ladies, I sure appreciate it. Thank you so much for doing this. They said, oh, you're welcome. So I got in the boat, and I head home. In my mind, I'm thinking, why were these three ladies fishing in December, 35-degree weather? That just never happens. You know, well, I just kept thinking that. When I get to the house, my hair is frozen. My clothes are just cold. My lips are turning blue. I walk in the house and open the door, and there my wife is on her knees, and she's praying. She turned around and she said, I knew something had happened. And I had to pray to God to bring me home. And only by the grace of God and her prayer, the saving those three angels to rescue me. There's no reason I'm here today. But I told her, I said, honey, you can pray me home. And I sure appreciate it. Go run me some water. Fritz today. But anyway, you know, God is good. Sometimes we seem like there's just no tomorrow and we're sinking. You know, He's there for us. You may not know it, the next person you see that's there to help you, that might be the angel God sent for you. But anyway, thank you so much for listening to that. Put it up with you. God bless you.